What is going on, guys? This is Chaotic Videos, and today I will be continuing the Conclave guide. This part of the guide will be covering the following game types: Annihilation and Team Annihilation. I will be reviewing those two game modes, and I will be explaining and showing you how to play them properly. I will also be giving a few of my own personal tips and tricks when it comes to those two game modes, as I do play them the most out of all the other game modes. Before we start, let me explain how this guide will be going. The first part, General Conclave Guide, is finished, and that explains the general basics of getting started and what you should be looking at to get started on Conclave. The rest of the guide will go as following. I will do 3 extra videos for 3 different game modes. This one will be covering Annihilation and Team Annihilation, as they are very similar. The next one will cover Cephalon Capture, and the last one will cover Lunaro. I will also be making an extra video, and this video will be about all my personal tips and tricks on how to master the PvP aspects of the game, and I will also be including all my personal loadouts and other loadouts that I suggest you try. And yeah, maybe even add them to your arsenal. Well, let's get right into the guide now, shall we? Annihilation and Team Annihilation. They both have one goal, and that is to capture Oro. One of them is a free-for-all game type, and the other one is a team-based deathmatch. Let us talk about Annihilation first. Annihilation is a free-for-all game mode that will put you up against up to 7 other enemies that you will have to fight in order to stand above all others. The objective of this game mode is that you must face off against 7 others and defeat them to capture their Oro. Oro will drop from the bodies of dead Tenno and can be captured by anyone who goes over it. However, the Oro will start to hover towards the person that defeated the Tenno. If no one defeated the Tenno, the Oro will hover in place and anyone can go over it to claim it for themselves. A Tenno can also reclaim their lost Oro if it is unclaimed by their opponent. The match is decided by either the first Tenno to capture 25 Oro, or the 10-minute time limit has been reached, and the Tenno with the most Oro will be declared the winner. Once you start up Annihilation game mode, you will either be put into a lobby, in which you will need to wait for at least one other opponent in order to start the match, or you will be thrown inside a match right from the get-go. It could be a starting one, or in the middle of one. I have even joined at the last 30 seconds of a match. Once you enter the match, you will be spawned and immune to any damage for a couple of seconds, or until you perform an action such as shooting or activating abilities. If you are new, I recommend first looking around the map and focusing on locating the energy stations, health stations, and ammunition stations, because if you are low on any of those 3 things, you can navigate your way to them and collect them, and then quickly get right back into the fight. Throughout the game, there will be an energy surge. At a certain point, this means each of the energy orbs will be turned into medium energy orbs, which will provide more energy to whoever collects them. There are currently, I believe, up to 8 different maps that are available for Annihilation, and hopefully more to come in later updates. That will be the basic information regarding Annihilation. It is extremely simple, and it should not take you too long to get the hang of it. Next, we will be covering Team Annihilation, which is extremely similar to the previous game mode, Annihilation, but in this one you will work with a team to complete your objective. Team Annihilation is a team deathmatch game mode that will put you in a team, which will be either Team Sun or Team Moon. You will be put in a team of up to 3 others in order to fight up to 4 enemies, and you can either work together for your goal or just do your own thing. The objective will be to gather 50 Oro for your team to win the match, or the team with the most Oro by the end of the 10-minute time limit will be victorious. Oro will be dropped from the bodies of dead Tenno, and can be captured by anyone who goes over it. However, the Oro will start to hover slowly towards the person that defeated the Tenno. If no one defeated the Tenno, the Oro will just hover in place and anyone can claim it for themselves. A Tenno can also reclaim their lost Oro, or their teammate's lost Oro, if it is unclaimed by the opponent. So you are not confused when you first enter. The enemies will be highlighted with a red outline to indicate they are from the opposing team. Your team will have no outline, so don't bother shooting them. It does no damage to your teammates. Just as in Annihilation game mode, once you start up a game, you will either have to wait for one or other opponents, or you will be put into a game right away. Once you enter the match, you will be spawned and immune to any damage for a couple of seconds or until you perform an action such as shooting or activating abilities. The spawn location for the energy, health, and ammo stations in Team Annihilation is the same for Annihilation, so no need to remember new tile sets. Just as in Annihilation, there will also be an energy surge in Team Annihilation as well. The map tile set will also be the same in Team Annihilation as it was for Annihilation, as well as there being up to 8 different maps with the possibility for more being added in future updates. That will be the basic information regarding Team Annihilation. It is extremely simple, and it should not take you too long to get the hang of it. Here are some tips for people looking to play either of those two game modes. Annihilation is extremely popular amongst all regions, and Team Annihilation is the second most popular game mode. But if you are still having issues finding a game, you can also change your current region to a different one. Each region, such as EU, NA, and Asia, have different peak points for Conclave. Just keep changing your region until you manage to find a match. Keep in mind, your ping might be affected depending on where you are located, so expect some lag. Many people leave a game if the opponent is overly skilled compared to themselves. Let them. Because whether or not you win by gathering the most Oro, or you win by the process of elimination, you will still be rewarded a win and receive the rewards as followed. Once you complete either Annihilation or Team Annihilation, you will be rewarded of up to 3 different rewards. A PvP mod will always be given, a chance to receive some credits, and also Endo as well. Well, that will be all for this part of the Conclave guide. I hope everyone enjoys it and has fun. Like if you could, comment if you wish, and subscribe if you can. And yeah, see you next time.